Hi everybody, I'm Tammy Woods, better known as Lone Palm Creates on Instagram. Today we're collaborating with Crafted Elements for the project that we're going to be working on, which is a little succulent tabletop. If you haven't tried these molds yet, they are amazing. I highly recommend you do. You can use them over and over again, and they are so worth the money. So what I've started is, this is all prepped. It's washed, dried, wiped it out with alcohol, used a little mold release spray, and then I started it. I put the gravel and the crystals through just for time's sake. Okay, so what I'm mixing is Alumilite's the Amazing Clear for the base coat. This is going to be laid over the gravel that I have here, and that will ensure that all my succulents stick and don't start floating around. So we're going to do a thin layer of this, and then I'm going to start adding the succulents. Make sure you mix well till all the little stringies are mixed together. Alumilite so far is my favorite. I've been playing with a lot of different resins. This one never lets me down. Very, very few bubbles. It does the job. Okay, my resin is all mixed. Now we're going to start pouring on the gravel that I have, and then we'll start placing the succulents. Just pour very, very slowly. Okay, here we go. Little side note here, I did put little markers in my mold where we're going to be drilling the legs of the table in. I mixed 10 ounces of resin for just the base coat here. We don't want it too thick. Okay, so first I'm going to use my large succulents, and I'm going to put them on top of those little markers where the legs are going to be drilled in. First of all, torch. Torch little bubbles. Okay, now here comes the big succulents. I'm going to set them on and just be creative. Do whatever moves you. So I've got my gravel and where my little wash is going to go through. Got my large succulents. And then just have fun with it. I just got these little succulents at Michael's. I kind of cut off the stems so they don't get too tall. You want to make sure that they're fully submerged in the resin. I've got some pretty little rocks. Gonna kind of scatter. So using these molds is gonna save you so much time. Before these came out, you would have actually had to build the mold, which doesn't always work out so well if you don't have the means, like me. You can use these over and over again. You're spending your time creating instead of constructing. Okay. So what I'm using, I got everything at Michael's, succulents, I have gravel, rocks, I've got these wood pieces. Anything that would occur in nature. Kind of just use your imagination. Okay. guys, we're back. It's been about 3 hours. Things are sticky and set up. Just to recap, I'm using the amazing Crafted Elements silicone mold, which is going to make our little succulent table. This time I've got the Lumalite Deep Pour. It's all ready to go. And I'm going to start pouring. Tim's working on the second batch. There's going to be, this whole mold is approximately 100 ounces, I would say. So here we go. When you're mixing, just a side note, when you're mixing, you don't want any lines. You can tell when it's ready, when it starts to get clear again. Okay, so here we go.
There we go.
Very slowly, very, very slowly. Even though these are silk, they take on a real look when they're in the resin. You can't tell the difference. Okay, I lied. We're gonna need a little bit more. All right, we've got all the resin in here. Got about 90 ounces. It's ready to go. It's going to sit about 48 hours or so, maybe slightly less because we're in Arizona and it's hot. It sets up a little quicker. Make sure you babysit it because some bubbles sometimes come up from the succulents or the rocks, which I'm getting a little bit more of than I have from the last succulent table that I did. If you look at this little table I have here, one flower had one bubble for about 12 hours. I'd come out about every hour and a half or so and pop them. So just torch it, watch it, and we'll see you guys on Monday, I'm guessing. Big 18 inch. It's the first time I've ever used this mold. It's huge. That table demolded. Tim's sanding it down now. We're starting at a low grit and we're going to work our way up to a high grit, almost to the point where we're polishing it. And then we'll go ahead and put a final coat or two over the top. This is going to be one of possibly several with sanding in between. The finishing, there's a lot of work in the finishing. And to be honest, we did get a couple little bubble areas. I don't think that's going to be a problem as long as we do our top coats. So here we go. Alive once top. We're back. So the flood coat was completed. Everything was sanded, cleaned off, ready for the legs. Tim's got the legs down, set up, and I'm going to let him tell you what he did. Just give you just a little rundown on that. So come on over.
Hey, how y'all doing? All right. What you want to do first is you put your legs down, you make your marks where you're going to put your screws. And what you want to use, it's basically a drill bit for glass or tile, so nothing's going to shatter, nothing's going to crack. You're going to put a little hole in to start, and that way you can put your self-tapping screws in. But what you want to do first, before you do any of that, you're going to line it up. You want to use some resin glue, this T88. Put it on your legs, set your legs down, put your screws in, and at least give it an overnight setup so that they're nice and sturdy. And you see, they just, it works out perfect. So that's how you gotta get the legs on, and after that, you're done.
Okay, one thing that I didn't mention is this, in the beginning we were putting tables together, just randomly drilling in, hoping that our screws weren't going to show through. That's where I put the markers in. I just put a colorful little stone right where they can, the legs can be drilled into a succulent, so they're not going to show from the top. So that was just one more little point that I wanted to add. Thanks.